last weekend, from the 1st to the 2nd of June 2019, Facebook's first CTF took place. A medium to heavy task in reverse engineering was Matryoshka, created from malware Unicorn. As the name suggests, it is about get through several layers, like peeling an onion, to open and reveal the core. In today's video, I show you my personal solution. This, however, was apparently not quite intended. It is an essential shortcut, but also requires something to think outside the box, and not just bluntly follow the prescribed path. In the task description, we are asked to examine the downloader, which was found on a Mac, to find the solution word. The main function consists of a few code blocks and quite a few variables. We discover 5 self-written functions, 2 functions with dynamically generated addresses, and some loops. Some conditions lead to the end of the program. The code block from hexd6d to hexdb7 is particularly interesting. Here, malware Unicorn congratulates us, and the string pointed to by S1 is output. This variable name was assigned during the automatic analysis. S1 is equal to RBP minus hex F0. First, we declare RBP minus 134 as I, RBP minus 138 as J, RBP minus 110 as memx. Now we substitute RBP minus 110 and RBP minus F0, RAX, and CL. Last, we create a for loop with the loop variable I equal to 3, the break condition I less hex 1f, and increment I by 1 after each loop pass. In this loop, S1 is particularly overwritten with the contents of memx. To be exact, bytes 3 through hex 1e are overwritten. S1 itself is generated in the first code block via memcopy, and contains fb and so on. First, we declare the variables RBP minus 58 as x1, minus 60 as x2, minus 68 x3, minus 6c as x4, minus 80 as x1 xor x2, minus 88 as x2 xor x3, minus 90 x3 xor x4, minus 98 as x4 xor rcx, and minus 78 as y. We insert the respective contents of RAX and RCX. Now we substitute RDX or EDX and RDE or EDE. We can delete the assignment for AZ because they are no longer used. We substitute the variables x1 to x4 and then all xm xor xn. Since every if condition returns the same result, we combine the condition with logical OR. Finally, we simplify label 4 and substitute GoTo. In summary, the following 4 equations must apply in order to get into the code block with the congratulations. Since XOR is its own inverse function, we can also rewrite the last equation. The variables x4 to x1 are generated in the previous 4 loops. First, we declare variable RBP minus 124 as K. Then we replace RCX and RBP minus hex 110. Now we replace EDX and then RAX and EAX. Finally, we again create a for loop with loop variable K equals 7, the termination condition K less 0, and reduce K after each loop by 1. In summary, we generate 3 64-bit and 1 32-bit integer variable from the first, second, third, 8 bytes and the last 4 bytes of memx. We declare RBP minus 140 as memx copy and read with BSD syscall 3 from standard input 0, hex 1e byte, to the address of memx copy. As noted earlier, XOR is its own inverse function. Furthermore, n XOR 0 equals n, and that the 32 most significant bits in X4 are 0. Therefore, from our four equations, we can calculate 32 most significant bits from x1, x2 and x3 by simply changing the equations. I have implemented the solution in Python 3, which displays the initial values, the calculated values, and the associated ASCII representation in a table. Somehow I had the impression I could already complete two of the three words. First, dog. Until then, I did not know what dog really means, but I have often read it in the Radari 2 fortunes and always associated it with dog in pirate talk. That's why I immediately thought of beard on the second word. Almost at the same time I had a second idea. The parameter alphabet of 10 digits, 52 letters and the underscore, so just 63 of the 256 possible characters, is not really large. This could therefore result in the possible parameters being restricted for a given x or function value. The following Python script therefore outputs the corresponding possible parent alphabets for each possible value of the codomain. Any possible digit, letter, and underscore is XORed with every possible digit, letter, or underscore, and if that suits the solution, the producer alphabet will be complemented. While writing the video script, it strikes me that it would of course have been even more efficient simply to compare every possible input XORed to the solution with hex 30 to 39, hex F5, 41 to 5A, and 61 to 7A. Bingo! The generator alphabets for the first and ninth letter, hex 68, and the second and tenth letter, hex 6F, are so small that you can output all options and find useful solutions manually. Especially as the letters in X2, X3 and X4 result directly from X1. We complement our first Python script by having the first 8 letters calculated and output the remainder of the solution word, depending on our XOR equation. I've only seen the word dog at the start of Radari 2, but I was not sure if you or yo was in front of it and would rather check the sources again. That fits almost perfectly. Yo is not at all in the respective producer alphabet, but 0 instead of O and underscore instead of blank. That would be better suited to Leetspeak. Yo dog, I heard you like flags. Yes, it was easier than I thought and probably does not reflect the preferred solution. In this video I have solved a medium CTF task with an easy shortcut using Cutter and Python. Fun fact, Team G+1, which meanwhile changed its name to visitg.coctf. Let's meet at another CTF. But do not be feared.
Believe me, it will be scary. See you later.
Should you be interested in Malware Unicorn's preferred solution, just write me in the comments or write me a message.